Today is the big day. Just wanted to capture this moment before, when I'm anticipating the day, so I can reflect on it later. No idea what this is gonna be like.
There you go, stepping out. There's a little courtyard in front of our light up that way. Hits the Camino. I'm gonna go in the church and say a quick prayer. I can hear the monks chanting. Let's go in and listen. I guess I am Jack from Ireland. Now we're on the Camino again. It's gonna be a good day. All right, it's light enough. We don't need the lamp anymore. We cross the highway here and head up into the woods. The climb so far is gradual, kind of like what it was coming out of Castellariz a few days, about a couple weeks ago, well, a week and a half. I really enjoyed La Meseta. Better after weeks of that kind of landscape. It's nice to be moving into this kind of landscape. But when I got sober in 1994, I was at a bookstore and I bought a little book called, I still have it, called The Little Zen Handbook. And it was just a bunch of like really short anecdotes and sayings and koans and things from the Zen Buddhist tradition. And one of my favorite is, when you are hungry, eat. When you are tired, rest. Fools will laugh at me, but wise men know what I mean. Sunrise coming through the trees. We have to climb up, and then we climbed up here. The road goes that way. People leave messages on rocks. This is my message. Dormammu, I've come to bargain. If you think I'm being flippant or taking the Camino lightly, you don't know me very well. You don't know what this film how it speaks to me. You don't know what that scene means to me. I don't want to get too overconfident because I know this gets harder, but I'm having a great time this morning. This so far has started as one of the best mornings. Oh, that's gorgeous. Go through. I am not getting any faces. I'm just getting the sun. So actually the body's moving through. Give it. It is just too beautiful up here. A lot of loose rocks and stuff. Good climb, love it. The guidebook says the path can get a little treacherous if it's been raining, but look at this day. Not a cloud in the sky, hasn't rained for a few days, and look at this view. I think it's really cool how my shadow is walking point for me right now. So the trail has flattened out briefly before the next climb. A little reprieve to catch my breath. Am I a little giddy today? I guess I am. There is Fonsabadon. Looks very quiet in Fonsabadon, but looks like there's a place to stop up ahead. So far, a beautiful day. Doesn't look like there's gonna be any weather to hinder us, which is good, because this is one of the more challenging parts of the Camino. As I've said, probably too goddamn many times. The road goes up the mountain. Beautiful up here. That's a very steep climb. Even steeper when I don't use my sticks because I'm taking video. Those furthest horizons, right there. I started beyond those, and I've walked all this way. And that absolutely astounds me. I don't say that in an arrogant way, like look what I've done. I say that in this humble way, like this Camino is showing me things I never thought I was capable of doing. No more excuses. If I can do this, I can do anything. Down there is the marker, and then it starts back up. there it is. It's not a great, ornate, awe-inspiring monument. It's a very simple thing. I have a lot of movie references. It's kind of like when Indiana Jones is picking the Holy Grail, and there are all those ornate, beautiful ones, and he sees the simple one. He says, that's the cup of a carpenter. I don't want...
I actually did two takes of this next clip with two different cameras, so pardon any discrepancies.
Pilgrims come here. This is a highest point on this peak. They drop rocks here. The rocks are kind of sacred. Some bring rocks from home to mark, to connect their home to the Camino. Some bring rocks and write things on them that they want. They're like prayers. I have a rock. I'm going to drop it in a minute. I wanted you to see. I'm also honoring our dead, my dead, the people that I love. First, there's my parents, mom and dad. Lost them in 2012 and 2016, respectively. Next, my cousin, Nick Neumeier. Lost him, I think, in 2019 or 2015. It was to cancer.
I'll just do this one now. This is my cat, Milo.
Those are the steps up to Puerto Marin, which is towards the last stage of the Camino. And it's a long story, but I photoshopped him sitting on the steps of Puerto Marin waiting for me to come across the bridge. My good friend Pat Ryan lost in 1984. Tragic loss. Our dear, 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 dear friend, Michael Sains. I saw him the night before he died. I got to say, I love you. Before I left, so that's kind of rarefied air. And finally, my friend Bob Aids, who died of cancer last year.
There's a bicycling painting behind him. He was a cyclist. I have mixed feelings about cyclists on the Camino, and so I'm trying to work through those feelings. But
when I came up, I had a conversation with some gentlemen from Wales who were walking the Camino, biking and walking.
And they gave me this. They were walking the Camino, two of them, their son and daughter had married, so they were in-laws.
And we talked and I hugged them all and then they said, they made these claws with the baby's footprints in the shell and they say, we're only giving them to special people and we can tell you're one.
Sorry, shutting it off.
So I wore baby Wilbur's neckerchief for the rest of the day, and although this section of the Camino was one of the hardest, I had more energy and more enthusiasm than I had ever had any other time on the Camino. I asked Neil and Nigel how we could stay in touch, and Nigel sent me a voicemail so I would have his phone number. When I tried to access it later on the Camino, I couldn't find it. It was only a week after I returned to the States from the Camino that the message finally showed up.
This Nigel on the Camino, Nigel Jones and Neil Hotel at the Iron Cross, Cruz de Ferro. All the best, right?
When I started uploading these videos, I sent links to the friends I had made during my walk. After the day one video, Neil wrote back the following words. It's strange to think that out of your 40-day Camino, we probably spent no more than about 30 minutes together, but what a half an hour. I believe the Camino is the only place on Earth which is capable of forging such a strong bond between strangers so quickly.
lot of places on the road down are rutted like this, so it's a little hard going.
We've leveled out again.
I believe that peak up there where the tower is Alto de Cerezales, which is just a tiny bit higher than the cross. This little house is officially a town called Manjarín. There is a refugio here. Manjarín, population 1. Look at all these signs he has here. Let's go get ourselves a selfie with them. This is the town. He is the only occupant. He's a little camera shy. Very friendly though. Highway right up there, hitting it. So far, this has been one of the best days. That's my favorite thing, walking through forest trails. Look how far we've come. There's the back of the marker. Over here, the Camino says, don't take the road up to Alto Cerezales. Get off on this little road. Well, I keep waiting for it to get to this world-class drop everybody tells me about. I don't want to be too flippant about it, because if I am, that's when it suddenly I'm like Man from Snowy River. We're kind of leveling off. Now we start our descent. I don't know if you can see a little patch of white way over there. That's where we're going. For one thing, it's not a very good trail. And you have to constantly be looking down, or you could, if you look up to look at the beautiful scenery. The other thing is, it's steady. So if you're carrying a backpack, gravity and the weight make you want to go faster than you should. You want to keep your sticks in front and below. Just the way everybody was describing it, I was expecting like Man from Snowy River. Like I said, if you've seen that movie when he goes down the hill on the horse. So that's the trail, and as you can see, it's not good. It's a lot of rocky. There is a path through there, but even that's not terribly stable. It goes without saying I'm not going to film while I'm walking, because that would just be too dangerous.
Wow, look at that stuff. Crazy.
This could be dangerous, but I'm gonna attempt to set up a shot. Oh. Highways down there. No idea. The road's decent enough for this small patch that I can actually film walking on it. More descent. Road has become quite the challenge again. Look at these lovely rocks. Paused here to get some water. Feels like we get further and further away. Still on the Camino, but no idea how far we have. Well, that far. Gee whiz. Well, I guess it's getting closer. Sure doesn't feel like it, though. Little village here. That must be El Acebo. So that must be Molin Seco over there. You can see how steep it's been. I got hot, but I'm keeping this on because the yin yang's a symbol of balance. And I definitely need balance all the way down this hill. Down there is El Acebo, and we're at siesta, so everything's probably closed. You sure are talking a lot, Rorschach. You comfortable? What a sweet girl. Or boy, whatever you are. Hi. Buen camino. Well, everything may be closed, but at least I can get clean water here.
There are some pilgrims back there resting, but I'm kind of feeling the walk right now, feeling it well. This has been a really good day for me physically. A memorial to a cycling peregrino. Look at his last name. It's good and hot here. I promised I would keep Wilbur's bandana on me, but I may have to take it off my neck. It's getting a little warm here. I'm trying to think where I'll put it. Maybe I'll just tie it around. I'll just tie it right here. That's a good place for it. Wow. Made a commitment to honor their grandson. Look. There's his footprints. I'm just so honored. That's pretty special. There's a little village on beyond there that we're heading towards. It's not too bad. Ooh, I spoke too soon. I better not videotape. Okay, now we're getting into some Man from Snowy River crap. And the only way to illustrate it is to maybe do this. There you can see the top of the road back there. Now I'm gonna go back and turn 180. You can't see the road, it's down there. So yeah, it's pretty steep. Standing kind of wide leg stanced. Flies are buzzing around like crazy. There are flies everywhere. Just walked through Riegos de... I can't remember. Anyway, we go through and come right here and they take us down this road. The Camino turns right into a dirt trail again. And this is the worst road yet. It's been steady decline for, oh, at least 12, 13 kilometers. Look, it's not really a road. It's just all this crappy eroded. You can see my feet here. These ruts and stuff. You have to have these sticks. You have to be very careful. Have to keep the sticks ever out in front of you and not get in a hurry. So that's what this afternoon has been like. My camera is running out of battery. I hope I have enough to get me, at least to show me coming into Ponferrada, which is about 11 kilometers away. Not loving the flies in my face, but everything else is fine. That must be Molin Seca. Just when you think you're out of it, you get more of this crap. The Camino is a playful last today. Could this be it? Could this be the end? The sun is getting around out in front of me now. There's Molin Seca down there, and I got so distracted looking at it, I wasn't looking at the road. Almost fell. Like a karma chameleon, Molin Seca comes and goes. It's over there somewhere. Not sure where. Well, coming in. Still got another 6 kilometers after this, but better than 16. Looks like they're finally coming out of siesta. So I might be able to get something to eat. We still have another 6 kilometers. Wish I had the time to truly explore here. Hope I'm still on the Camino. I need to check and make sure.
Hey, what's up, buddies? Hi, guys. Black kitties are good luck.
Now with our phone battery's last dying breath, there is Ponferrada. Look at that view as we walk along the freeway. You like that? I like that. Because I conquer mountains.